I'm Emily Werner. I'm the curator here at the Huntington Historical Society. It's our 120th year, and we really are interested in branching out and connecting with different community groups. We're really excited about this collaborative exhibit between the Huntington Historical Society and the Huntington Arts Council. And we wanted to partner with them to bring new audiences to both our collection and their gallery. So we came up with this idea for a juried art show called Interpretive Sights, Art and Facts. So we met with the Arts Council last year to start picking up these objects. We have about 10,000 objects in our collection, so it's really difficult to narrow down and just pick six. But we wanted to pick objects that were both visually appealing and also had interesting stories and interesting connections to Huntington's history. So the name of the show is called Interpretive Sights, Art in Facts. And the idea was to kind of tie together art and history by using our historical objects as inspiration for new art to be created. We really wanted to bring our collection to a new audience and see how it's still relative today. So the pieces that people are creating don't necessarily have to be exact replicas of what they're seeing here, but they should serve as inspiration points to create new art and new experiences. So the first piece we have is a collection of ephemera related to the blizzard of 1888, which struck Huntington and cities up and down the East Coast in March of 1888. So the main piece that we have on display here is a letter written by 11-year-old Margie Crossman while she was snowbound on her family's farm in Lloyd Harbor. So the second piece we have is a collection of hair jewelry dating from the 19th century. Hair has a long history of being used as a token of remembrance. It doesn't decay or lose its color, so it's really becomes kind of a tangible connection to a loved one in the face of death or distance. The third piece we have are three pincushions that date from around 1900. They're made from Atlantic Bay scallop shells, painted velvet with seaweed and floral designs. The fourth piece we have is this Votes for Women photograph from 1912. Pictured are Elizabeth Freeman, who's an English suffragette, and Rosalie Gardner Jones, who's a suffragette from Cold Spring Harbor. They're pictured here when they campaigned around Long Island for women's right to vote in the spring of 1912. So the fifth piece that we have is a lingerie dress, which dates to about circa 1904. Lingerie dresses are called that because they often use the same fabrics and decorations as women's undergarments of the time. The sixth piece that we have are a selection of three sketches by local artist Woodhull Young. They date from around the 1930s to the 1950s. Woodhull was kind of a big personality around town, and people would go to visit his studio in Hale Site, which was actually on the foundation of the house where he was born. And so they would come and sit to watch him paint and chat with him. And just as they were leaving, he would pull a sketch off the wall and give it to them as a gift to the departing guest. He signed these paintings with three little dots in triangular formation.